meeting, the organization meeting of the Board of School Directors of the Owen J. Rockford School District will come to order. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance and presentation of colors by the Navy Junior Reserves Officer Training Corps, followed by a moment of silence, present colors.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please join us in a moment of silence as we reflect on those serving in the United States Armed Forces, both past and present, elected leaders for the state of Pennsylvania, and elected leaders for our nation. We have much to be thankful for in our community. Color guard, post colors.
Carry. Color. Ready, cut. Right turn. March. Forward. March. Pose. Colors. Ready. Turn. Forward. March.
Please be seated.
Jackie, I'd like to tell the agenda that we have a fairly significant audience participation. If I give a minute to explain everybody what we're doing, it might be helpful. It's kind of an archaic prescribed by the school code procedure. What we're going to have right now is required by law that every December, the first week, that the board reorganize. And that means we're essentially elect officers. What happens is, what just you saw take place is, the board secretary calls the meeting to order. And then we're going to elect a temporary chairman among the three what are called holdover board members in the school district. And holdover board members are folks that are still in office. And then we'll have the procedure where we'll have the oath of office, certificates of election, etc. It's all prescribed on the agenda. And we will take a public comment after we elect a temporary president. Again, for those of you that may be new here, I'm not sure if we have many of those, but the board allows, as I understand it, 3 minutes for public comment. And so keep your public comment, though, to the agenda items on this meeting, because as soon as we get done this meeting, which I anticipate will not take terribly long, then the board will adjourn this meeting and we'll call order the regular business meeting of the board for December. So then there will be appropriate public comment for agenda items on that agenda. So please appreciate there's two agendas tonight, the reorganization agenda, which will elect officers. We already have in place the secretary and treasurer, which really is a president and vice president. Jackie will now hold the election for the temporary chair. The temporary chair will then take the public comment and hold the election for officers. When we get to that, by the way, everybody interprets a little differently. I do not believe, and it's always been our opinion, that you do not need a second for nominations. I don't know what your custom here is. Certainly, if you want to do that, you can, but Robert's rules do not require a second. What we should do, though, is hopefully after there are no more nominations, hear that usually by a pause in the action. Then at that point, we should go the formal round of closing the nominations. Then I guess Jackie will have a roll call at that point on the nominees. Okay, do your thing.
All right.
Sorry.
All right, thank you, Mr. Davis. The first item we're going to do, or I should say the next item, is that we'll provide a roll call of all holdover board members and incoming board members. So when I say your name, please signify your presence by stating present. Mrs. Melissa Booth? Present. Mr. Carl Miner?
Present.
Ms. Leslie Crawford? John Neal?
Present.
Kathleen DiMaria?
Present.
Mr. Paul Frio?
Present.
Mr. John Melisek?
Present.
Mrs. Jennifer Munson?
Present.
Mrs. roll call vote, establish a meeting date, place, and purpose of this meeting at the official school board meeting held on January 28, 2019. Proper notices have been posted on the administration building bulletin board, front entrance of the administration building, and all educational centers 24 hours prior to the reorganization meeting date. Each school board member has been properly notified in writing at least 5 days in advance per section 402 of the school code of the meeting date, place, and purpose of the reorganization meeting, as stated by Mr. Davis. The next item is item 4.1, which is accepting nominations for election of a temporary president. May I have nominations for a temporary president?
I'd like to nominate Ms. Booth.
Are there any additional nominations for temporary president? Seeing none, and if there's no objection, I'll declare the nominations closed. The nominations are closed. Mr. Davis,
should we
go to a roll call vote?
Oh, yes. It doesn't have to be a roll call.
Okay.
We should vote as long as we can discern who voted out.
All in favor for Melissa Booth?
Aye.
Aye.
Well, just so it's clear, only if any of all voters can vote, it's fine. So,
we're practicing.
Lastly, Melissa, and all of them voted in favor.
All voted in favor?
Yes.
Say aye.
Aye.
Thank you. Thank you. Now I'll turn it over to Mrs. Booth. Thank you. Now's the time for public comment before we get into the event. Our new members this evening, as stated earlier, are Mr. John Deal, Mrs. Kathy DiMarino, Kathleen, sorry, Mr. Paul Friel, Mr. John Melnizek, Ms. Jennifer Munson, and Ms. Lydia Stutzman. Mrs. Brumrein, we will then read the certificates. Do you want to have a public comment now or after the swearing in?
Let's do it after the swearing in. It's not prescribed in the school code.
Okay, we will do the public comment after the swearing in. Okay, I will read the certificates of election,
yes.
Mrs. Booth. The County of Chester, November 25th, 2019. We, the undersigned members of the County Board of Elections of Sept County, hereby certify that after tabulating the votes cast at the municipal election held on the 5th day of November 2019 in Sept County, it appears that John Deal was duly elected to the office of school director, unexpired 2-year term, O.J. Roberts School District at large in the County of Chester. County of Chester, November 25th. All right, we have election certificates for Mr. Davis and the County of Chester as for Kathy DiMarino, school director for OJR District at Large. For Mr. Paul Friel, duly elected to the office of school director, OJR District at Large. Mr. John Melnizek, school director, OJR School District at Large. Mrs. Jennifer Munson, duly elected school director, OJR School District at Large. Ms. Lydia Stutzman, duly elected to the office of school director, OJR District at Large. Yes, we would like the Honorable Mr. John Hipple to come forward to administer the oath.
State your name, solemnly swear or affirm.
I, John Deal, solemnly swear and affirm.
That I will support, obey, and defend.
That I will support, obey, and defend.
The Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of this Commonwealth.
The Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of this Commonwealth.
And that I will discharge the duties of my office with fidelity.
And I will discharge the duties of my office with fidelity.
Congratulations, my name. the arena, please. Does Ms. Di Marino have any family? Right hand, thank you. Please repeat after me. I state your name, do solemnly swear or affirm. Swear that I will support, obey, and defend the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of this Commonwealth, and that I will discharge the duties of my office with fidelity. Congratulations. State your name, do solemnly swear or affirm.
I, Paul Real, do solemnly swear.
That I will support, obey, and defend.
I support, obey, and defend.
The Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of this Commonwealth.
The Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of this Commonwealth.
And that I will discharge the duties of my office with fidelity.
I will discharge the duties of my office with fidelity.
Congratulations. John Leslichek. Did you say that right?
No.
Correct me.
Melnizek.
Leslichek. Sorry. State your name, do solemnly swear or affirm.
I, John Novak, do solemnly swear and affirm.
That I will support, obey, and defend.
That I will support, obey, and defend.
The Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of this Commonwealth.
Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of this Commonwealth.
And that I will discharge the duties of my office with fidelity.
That I will discharge the duties of my office with fidelity.
Congratulations. Jennifer Munson. Please repeat after me. I state your name, you solemnly swear or affirm. Support, obey, and defend.
That I will support, obey, and defend.
The Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of this Commonwealth.
The Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of this Commonwealth.
And that I will discharge the duties of my office with fidelity.
And that I will discharge the duties of my office with fidelity.
Congratulations. Thank you. state your name, do solemnly swear or affirm.
I, Denise Kessler.
That I will support, obey, and defend.
I support, obey, and defend.
The Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of this Commonwealth.
The Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of this Commonwealth.
And that I will discharge the duties of my office with fidelity.
Discharge the duties of my office with fidelity.
Congratulations.
Judge, thank you very much. We appreciate your time for the benefit of the audience. His Honor does this on a purely voluntary basis as community service, and I'm sure I speak for everyone tonight that it's much appreciated.
Well, thank you for having me. It was an honor to be here this evening.
Yes, Mrs. Booth, thank you. Mrs. Booth?
Yes.
Mr. Beal?
Yes.
Ms. DiMarino?
Yes.
Mr. Friel?
Aye.
Mr. Malasita?
Yes.
Mr. Meyer?
Yes.
Ms. Munson?
Aye.
Ms. Brockett? Aye. Ms. Stetson?
Yes.
Unanimous in favor of Mr. Carlmeier? We will now open the floor for nominations for Vice President for the upcoming school year session.
I would like to place Leslie Robin in nomination.
Also second.
Are there any other nominations to be heard? We will close the floor unless someone objects. All right, we'll close the floor. Mrs. Carmine, will you please lead the roll call vote?
Yes, thank you. For the office of Vice President, Ms. Proctor, Mrs. Booth?
Aye.
Mr. Beal?
Aye.
Ms. DiMarino?
Aye.
Mr. Friel?
Aye.
Mr. Malasita?
Aye.
Mr. Meyer?
Yes.
Ms. Munson?
Aye.
Ms. Proctor?
Aye.
Ms. Stetson? The vote is unanimous for Ms. Proctor for the office of Vice President. Congratulations.
And now I'm going to be very careful to make sure I get this right. That's all I can tell them. Thank you. Our incoming members this evening are John Deal, Kathleen DiMarino. I'm going to start calling you Kathy, if that's okay.
Whatever.
Paul Friel, John Malasek, Jennifer Munson, with Ms. Dustman. Mrs. Cromrine, will you please read their certificates of election? Yeah, we did that.
We did
that. She pointed to the top of the page. There you go. I am on the wrong page. President. promises to be a busy year, and I know I will be counting on your help as we tackle the many challenges ahead of us. There are a few more things we need to address before we can wrap up the organizational meeting and adjourn to our regular business meeting. Every member will receive a link to a survey listing the various committees of the board. Under our board policy 005, the president appoints surveys of the standing committees. To assist me in doing this and participating in the process, I ask that each board member complete the survey, indicating your desires and preferences as a committee and representative assignments within the next 10 days. Finally, every member has before them a schedule of regular board meetings through July 2020 as previously adopted and incorporated into the current school calendar. If members of the board have a conflict, please let us know. We will reserve any action on schedule changes until our January meeting. Quick question. Do we normally do two public comment? Do we do a non-agenda at the end? We'll now move to item 9 on the agenda, which is comments from the board. Is there anybody on the board that has any comments they'd like to make this time? Very efficient. Item 10 is comments from the superintendent of schools. Any comments I could like?
I want to say congratulations to each and every one of you, and I look forward to working with you in the upcoming school year.
Thank you very much. And now moving on to item 11, which is adjournment. We will adjourn the reorganizational meeting and then proceed on to meeting the following our regular business meeting. Thank you.
I want your opposite of Jesus.